Winner of the Hamletonian 2018, Scott Ceron, Atlanta. Say something about this tremendous mare.
She's the best horse I've ever sat behind. Filly, colt, I mean, I've won the Hamletonian before, but she has no flaws. She goes into those races as calm and cool as a horse can be, beautifully gated. She's versatile. As much as I show front end with her, she can come off helmet even better.
Lots of people were a little bit frightened after the first heat. It was like you were trying to set a world record.
Yeah, you know, that was on me because she's so fluid and gets over the ground so easy, and she felt great. You know what? The race kind of got away from me. I could have backed her down, no problem. Instead, she just kind of rolled and got away from me. But yeah, I was a little worried. Nobody wants to be going backwards at the finish line heading into the second heat. So I was worried, but then I recouped for the final.
Did you think she was going to recover perfectly after that race?
It's hard to say, only because I've never actually asked her to give me everything. So when I asked her to give me everything and she did, I didn't know how you'd bounce back, especially for a filly with maybe an attitude, but she's so easy going. She probably fell asleep in between heats and didn't know why I wanted her to go back out and do it again. But, you know, I was able to rate her and go nicer fractions. And I knew, even though the elimination was so tough, that if she's a champion, she's going to come back out and she's going to deliver. And she did.
She sounds like a perfect girlfriend.
She's perfect. Yeah. She's rich. She's rich now, too.
I also wonder, what were you thinking of when you were driving out to the final?
Like when I was just jogging in the post parade, I was I just wanted to keep her nice and quiet, and then going to the gate, I just wanted to make sure I had her attention so that I could do whatever I wanted in that race. I felt like I was going to have to control it. Maybe some people were going to be scared that I went those big fractions, that maybe she's grabby. So I felt like I would create that image that nobody would power move on me. I'd be able to command it and back off the fractions, and I did, and it worked out.
So is that that why you won, that tactic? Why you won?
Yeah, and because I knew Tactor's horse, he wasn't going to force him to do anything. He was going to keep him nice and balanced and just make sure he grinded his way up there. And Tietrich's horse, I knew, was going to try to just follow him. And it was all the right moves. So when I was able to go 55-2 to the half, that was the difference.
What does it mean to you to win the Hamletonian with your father's horse?
It's massive. You know, I've won this race before. I know how global it is and the impact it makes on the horse, the driver, the trainer, the owners. It's the biggest race for us ever. So the fact that I did it for my dad, he's never raced in the Hamletonian, let alone put a filly in. So it was a tall order, but she delivered.
How are you going to celebrate tonight?
My whole family's here from Canada because I told them I was going to win. So they all came down, and who knows, we'll go out and have some fun. I got to go back and race tomorrow afternoon anyway.
Well, have a nice evening.
Thank you very much.